I had started learning Japanese at a very young age. But it was, I wasn't happy because it was really difficult to progress. ギリシャ旅行を案内する会社を始めます。
すごい、すごいですね。かっこいいですね。ギリシャで育ったので、好みに合わせたプランできます。すごい。おすすめの場所はどこですか、ギリシャで。おすすめの場所は、アテネのパルデの神殿と、ソニオの先のポセイドン神殿です。そうですか。ポセイドン神殿の見える景色は本当に綺麗です。
そうですか。もし屋台に来たら、案内できますよ。ぜひ行ってみたいです。ギリシャに興味を持っている日本人の方々にギリシャを紹介したいです。とても楽しみです。もしよかったら何か一緒にできませんか。そして何かアドバイスをいただけませんか。連絡お待ちしています。よろしくお願いします。
How was it in the beginning?
It was super hard. I was extremely scared, super shy. If I have like a perfect sentence and I it up by heart, practicing it, you know, once I cover this part, becoming super fluent, realizing that you have the confidence to talk and actually say these things, I'm here. Pushes you forward to move ahead and learn other things.
Yeah.
I'm an introvert. Just
Don't be afraid to talk.
ギリシャです。ギリシャのアテネです。アテネはトルコの近く。お仕事はお返しの会社。お返しの会社、はいはい。
会社の社員ですか。いえ、お返しの会社を経営しています。お菓子のことよく知っていますか。2019年前に会社を
It's tomato sauce, caper, onion, and a little bit of garlic. It's cooked together.
PR
Doganoglou, George と申します。 ギリシャ人で、ギリシャのアテネに住んでいます。趣味は運動と日本語勉強と映画で、特にマトリックスと忍術が大好きです。子供の頃から日本が大好きでしたから、日本人ともっと関わりたいです。なので、日本人にギリシャ旅行を案内する会社を始めます。ギリシャに興味を持っている日本人の方々にギリシャを紹介したいです。 とても楽しみです。もしよかったら何か一緒にできませんか。そして何かアドバイスをいただけませんか。連絡お待ちしています。よろしくお願いします。
wonderful.
Domo.
Domo. Ah, hi, 日本人です。
Ah, そうだ。
日本語上手ですね。
あ、ありがとうございます。ギリシャ人で、ギリシャのアテネに住んでいます。
ああ、そうですか。
はいはい、そうですけど、子供の頃から、
うん、
日本が大好きでした、大好きでした。
日本の何が好きですか？
日本の技術と、
うん、
志村けんや。
志村けん？
はいはいはい。忍術と、うん、うん、太極拳のなどの格闘技が大好きです。うん、子供の頃から日本についてのつながりはなかったです。
うん、
自分でも何度も、考えていましたが、
うん、
まだによく、理由はわからないんですが、
うん、
日本と日本人と、大好きです、
うん。
もしかしたら前世は日本人だったのかもしれません。
うん、
日本人に、
うん、
ギリシャ旅行を案内する会社を、うん、始めます。
すごい、すごいですね。かっこいいですね。
ギリシャで育ったので、
うん、
好み合わせてプランできます。
すごい、うん。おすすめの場所はどこですか、うん、ギリシャで。
うん、おすすめの場所は、
うん
うん、アテネのパルテノン神殿と、
うん、
スニョン岬の、ポセイドン神殿です。
うん、へえ、そうですか。うん。
セイドン神殿の、
うん、
見える景色は本当に綺麗です。
そうですか。へえ。
もしアテネに来たら、案内できますよ。
ぜひ行ってみたいです。おすすめの食べ物は何ですか？
いろいろな有名な食べ物がありますが、
うん。
一つは、ファーバです。
うん。へえ、
うん。
ファーバ？
ファーバは、潰した、ファーバという豆と、
うん、
細かく切った玉ねぎです、うん。大体ギリシャ人は、食べ物かけて食べます。趣味は健康的なライフスタイルで、運動と、
うん
うん、日本語勉強です。子供の頃から、
うん、
は、
うん、
日本人ともっと関わりたいです。
じゃあ日本人の友達たくさんできるといいですね。
Okay, so that's quite a, I mean, it seems like a simple question,、うん、but it's quite difficult.、うん、I mean, I had started learning Japanese at a very young age,、
うん、
back in 1990.
Mm.
And of course, back then, you know, there was no internet, no YouTube. It was very difficult to progress. And、I was studying from a book.、It was really, really difficult. So,、but I tried to learn.、And、eventually I got the JLPT N4, but the,、the old N4.、And then after that, I continued studying on my own.、but it was, I wasn't happy because it was really difficult to progress because、I didn't have any interaction. I didn't have、anyone to talk to. And eventually I gave up. I was 25 years old. I think I gave、up. I was actually disappointed at this because I really wanted to achieve it.、And so I was 25. So this is, so then 11 years later, so、last year,、I decided I would give it one more try. I'd try once more and see what would happen. And then I found you, of course. I started the lessons.
How was it in the beginning?
It was super hard. I was extremely scared, super shy. I'm still am an introvert. Just
No, it's not look like.
It doesn't look like it, I know.
Anymore.
I practice, I guess. But yeah, so what happened was I jumped in and I started, I literally forced myself to follow, especially all the speaking classes. It was like my brain did not want to, think in Japanese. But I just kept on trying, really. I just kept on trying. And then eventually things started getting a little bit easier because I got used to talking, actually. So the first thing I need, it was very important for me was to get comfortable with making mistakes. We're always worried about, oh, mistake, the other person is judging me. I understand that because I think we, with the preparation of my introduction, it helped me like boost my confidence a lot. If I have like a perfect sentence and I learn it off by heart, and I keep on practicing it, so I need to know what I'm saying. So when I'm learning the sentence, I know the grammar. I do this. I learn the grammar of words. So as I'm practicing it, I'm practicing the speaking part. Plus the grammar, plus so it really helps me like improve on all levels. This is my personal experience and opinion. So you know, focus on grammar first and speaking later. But if we think about it, what is the purpose of that? Like, because ultimately I personally want to talk with people. Focusing on the things I want to actually say, statistically, it's going to allow me to communicate with people saying the things I want to say. You know, once I cover this part, becoming super fluent, realizing that you have the confidence to talk and actually say these things, I'm here. Pushes you forward to move ahead and learn other things. You know, if you want to become a speaker, you have to spend time speaking. If you want to become good at reading, you just practice your reading. Wherever you spend your time, you become better at it, whatever it is you do. I think if I was studying a European language, I think I could probably study on my own. Because the mentality of the European languages is like in all the countries, it's pretty similar. Like if you want to say something, you can just translate the verbs and like 90% of the time it will make sense. French, German, like Italian. But what I've experienced that with Japanese, that's not the case. You can say, you can translate it, but it might not make any sense. And you have to learn. It's like literally learning from zero. You can't, sometimes translating into Japanese doesn't work. Maybe for simple stuff. Maybe they will understand you, but it sounds very weird speaking. They definitely need someone to speak with or speak to, because otherwise you won't know if what you're saying is actually correct or not. Well, I mean, the dictionary will say, yeah, you're correct, and Google might say it's correct, but it might not be the common phrase that they use. I really feel that my life depends on this. Do you know what I mean?
But for me, like, your goal is you as an instructor, the next level is to teach this, you know, master course.
I will do it in the future. I will do it. I don't know when, but I plan to do it because I want to become fluent. Yeah, maybe 2 years. 2 years. I want to become fluent. I can do this.
You can do this. Like, so yeah, 2 years.
If my progress continues at this rate for 2 years, yeah, I think it'll be. I'll be very good. Really.
Yeah. ありがとうございます. So that's why let's expand. Let the people say, why you can speak so much, you know? Even you're not living in Japan. So, if you want to change your life with a Japanese speaking skill, seriously, join our master course, 2 months. So, you can be ready to communicate with Japanese people after 2 months. So, for example, you can maybe make Japanese friends, you can enter the Japanese company, you can try more conversation with Japanese people every day. So, that's why your speaking skill grow up every day. So, these 2 months,
We're gonna make a perfect the foundation of your Japanese speaking skill. Then you can start speaking with Japanese people, real life or social media, on Instagram, on Facebook, or anywhere that you can actually have the chance to speak. So if you really want to change your life, seriously use Japanese communication skill, speech skill, presentation skill, for the business, for the private. Let's join the master course.